This week, Miami-Dade County Commissioners voted 10-2 in favor of a resolution that local aviation officials and Mayor Carlos Gimenez are calling, quote, ludicrous, end of quote. The mayor is even considering a veto. The new rule says that if a checked bag is wrapped by a company other than SafeWrap, which is the only company within Miami International Airport to hold this concession, it won't be allowed into the baggage handling system at MIA. Commissioners in favor of the change argue the new rules would boost revenue-sharing dollars SafeWrap has to pay the county. But airport executives say the change will just bring delays and higher fees for passengers. Aside from the cost and inconvenience to passengers, does this tell us anything about county commission priorities? Who are they serving? Joining me to discuss this issue, we welcome Emilio Gonzalez, Director and Chief Executive Officer for the Miami-Dade Aviation Department. Emilio, good to see you.
Thank you, Helen. Good seeing you again.
So this kind of is reminiscent of the county trying to protect monopolies. We saw it with Uber and Lyft, and we see it now with SafeWrap. The fascinating thing is that SafeWrap is the venue to be able to put plastic wrap around your suitcases, which a lot of clients, a lot of customers use if they're traveling to Venezuela, if they're traveling to Cuba in particular. And they like doing it themselves or going to an outside vendor because it's less expensive than what SafeWrap says. But the county commission is saying that there is a cost benefit to Miami-Dade County by having them just go through SafeWrap. Why are you against this?
Well, and thank you for having me. The issue is one that that I got very passionate about the commission hearing, because the reason SafeWrap wants to do this is because they're arguing that they are challenged in possibly making the revenue that they're required to pay the airport, and that ostensibly there's money on the table, quote unquote, for the airport. From my perspective, I think that there's an avenue for this. I think that, the company, by the way, it's a very good vendor. I have no complaints about them or their performance. But there's an avenue for this, and that is to petition the commission to adjust the minimum annual guarantee clauses in their contract. What we're doing now is we're trying to address a financial matter with an operational matter, which would require the airport to take people out of their current jobs right now and turn them into plastic wrap police.
What do you mean?
Well, if you have your bag wrapped by a company on the beach, or by the way, there are many different little companies out there. They're usually mom and pop outfits. They'll come to your house if you call them. They'll come to your hotel, or some hotels offer the service as an amenity. They'll wrap a bag for you for $6 or $7. And then you take it to the airport and you check in. And the issue then becomes, if this legislation goes through, I'm gonna have to have personnel at the airport to stop people and say, excuse me, Ms. Ferre, that bag you have there has illegal wrap on it. You're gonna have to take it off and then go into that line and get the authorized wrap on it. If for some reason you get past those airport individuals, then you check in at a counter and an American or a Lufthansa or a Delta employee is gonna say, I'm sorry, I can't take your bag because it has unauthorized wrap. And you can just imagine the delay there in trying to process passengers through. What do I do? I don't want to take it off. If I take it off, I have to go over there. If I go over there, I have to make another line and then come back in.
You might lose your flight.
You could. Well, first of all, you're going to miss your flight. Secondly, you're going to pay twice now, because you may have paid $6 or $7 off airport. Now you're going to be made to pay between $10, $20, and $30 on airport. So this is an operational issue for me, and I think it's one that is not worth the effort to try and accomplish what folks want to accomplish for this company, which is increase their revenue.
Well, you look at it from a customer's perspective. The customer is confused. The governor has already paid. The customer needs to get on the flight as safe and quickly as possible. That's impeded. What is the position of the airlines?
Well, the airlines are vehemently against it. In fact, they have been calling me. They have been writing me letters, and it isn't very bland letters. These are very blatant. These are very upfront letters.
Because actually, they're going to be the face of the ones receiving the complaints.
It. Right. And
so in other words, they're going to be the sheriffs.
Absolutely.
Having to enforce a very unpopular ordinance.
And imagine it's their processes that are going to suffer. If they budget, say, this isn't a right number, 3.5 minutes to process a passenger coming through. That number may slip to 6 minutes. Now you're gonna spend more time processing passengers. People may miss their flights. Listen, the airlines refuse. In fact, in the letters that I'm getting, two things come out. One, they vehemently oppose the legislation and are asking the mayor in writing to veto it, which I think is pretty significant. And secondly, they said they're not gonna enforce it. It doesn't matter what they pass, they will refuse to enforce this legislation.
Have you had conversations with SAFROP? What do they tell you?
Well, I had conversations with them early on. Their point originally, and I've spoken to their principals, is that they feel that the outside baggage industry is eating into their business, and that they feel that the airport, the county, whomever, should do something to mitigate that. Unfortunately, what has happened is, when that didn't work out, then I started getting complaints that, because we're using the wrong baggage wrap, there's an increase in workmen's compensation claims. And that got some people all wound up. When we researched it, it turned out that there are no workmen's compensation claims based on bag wrap.
Let me ask you something. TSA. Does TSA care one way or another about the type of wrap, if it's done by SAFROP or anybody else?
TSA could care less. And the reason I say that, and I'm not being flippant in my answer, is TSA will accept any bag that the airline puts on a belt. They reserve the right to open any bag they want. So whether it was done in Doral, in Miami Beach, or on the airport property itself, they could care less. If they need to open your bag, they're going to open your bag.
So what does the county commission tell you? Have you spoken to commissioners? There's only two who voted against. Most would say voted in favor of the consumer. Commission Chair Jean Munestim and Danielle Levine Cava. Commissioner Sally Heyman was absent from the dais at that time, possibly traveling. So what do the commissioners who voted in favor of it say?
Well, I mean, they look at it from a different perspective. They seem to feel that this is a consumer protection issue, that if you're having your bag wrapped off airport and TSA were to unwrap it, that you're gonna lose your money, because the way the structure is now, the only bags that are rewrapped after TSA unwraps it are those bags wrapped by the current vendor at the airport.
But TSA does that randomly.
Exactly.
So it's the likelihood, I mean, and it's always possible,
but the thing
buyer
is,
beware,
the
how's
thing
that?
Is, the thing is, and they don't care. And you know, the mayor had a great point at the commission meeting in that we really don't know where we're headed with this, and it may turn out that the cost of implementing this might be worse than what is being asked, or to mitigate these financial issues. Right now, my budget's been submitted. I don't have a line item for, quote, plastic police, which means that I'm gonna have to pull people from different functions of the airport to walk the terminals 24/7 looking for unauthorized plastic.
And this kicks in around Christmas time?
Well, Commissioner Sosa offered a friendly amendment where she was, were this to actually happen, we would have 60 days to come up with an implementation plan. She was trying to be helpful, but 60 days from now is essentially Christmas. So we would have to be implementing this at the busiest time of the year for Miami International Airport. Hence the reason the airlines, who theoretically should be benefiting from this, are vehemently against it.
Absolutely. It's fascinating to me to see that SAFROP is trying desperately to protect their business, which is today a monopoly under this ordinance, and at the same time they're so worried about losing money, they're spending money on 6 or 7 lobbyists easily, which is telltale about how things are done in the county.
Well, I don't follow their lobbyists. I made a very impassioned yet unsuccessful plea at the commission hearing to try and get folks to understand that if this is an economic issue for the company, let's handle it in the right economic venue. Let's not turn the airport on its head to try and accommodate one vendor. And then you actually end up also with the whole issue of a slippery slope. What's next? You know, if your baggage is anything other than Samsonite, do we have to not accept it?
Or can you not take food from home to eat at the airport because we have airport vendors that sell sandwiches.
Correct. I mean, you can.
I mean, it was like you can take it as far as you want, and then you're going to have food police.
You could play this out forever, and then who's going to tell that little old lady who wrapped her bag, you know, with wrap that she bought at Home Depot, ma'am, you got to take that off. Why? Because it's against the law. Imagine that. I genuinely think the airline industry and the airport industry is pretty insular. We all know each other. And I can just imagine the stories that are going to come out. You know, Miami now has a platoon of plastic police roaming the terminals, telling people, you got to take that plastic off.
It is thought that Mayor Carlos Gimenez, Miami-Dade Mayor Gimenez, is going to veto this. Have you had any conversations with him regarding that?
Not yet. I mean, he's made some statements leading to that, but I'll be speaking with the mayor later today. But I think that at this point, it would be a very wise move. If he asked for my opinion, I would definitely support a veto. In fact, our airline partners not only support a veto, they're asking him to veto. Well, so that should tell you a lot about who feels what about this issue. Because when the airport says this is not a wise move, when the airlines say this is not a wise move, when TSA said, I mean, they look at me and they go, what? Makes you wonder.
It does make you wonder, and it makes you wonder who the county commission is serving. Fascinating. I know Doug Hanks has done some work from the Miami Herald. He's done some work on who have been beneficiaries from Safe Wrap, and Commissioner Jose Pepe Diaz received about $13,000 from Safe Wrap executives and related entities during his 2014 re-election campaign. He is just one. Of course, Commissioner Juan Carlos Zapata is the big champion of this. Ironic, Juan Carlos Zapata is spending 4 days out of every week in Boston doing a Harvard MBA that he tried doing it at taxpayers' dime as well. The world of politics in Miami-Dade County, it's absolutely fascinating. Emilio Gonzalez, thank you so much for joining us today.
Thank you for having me. Appreciate it.